it's always amazing being in the presence of John Carlos and other living heroes, because their struggles are not just about the past, but they're about the present. That's why I appreciate John being here. You know, 1968 was inspirational in so many ways, and it was also sad in many ways. Chicago, of course, in 1968 is known for different things. Soon after the incredible assassination of Martin Luther King, all across the country, African and Native American neighborhoods went up in rebellion against all the symbols of bigotry and oppression in their neighborhoods and cities. And of course, one of the most notorious incidents in Chicago was when Mayor Daley issued his shoot-to-kill orders in the city of Chicago. And the truth is that those shoot-to-kill orders really haven't really been rescinded in the last 45 years. This year, 43 people have been shot by the Chicago Police Department, almost overwhelmingly African-American in the city, including Jamel Cannon, who was a 13-year-old who was shot 8 times by the Chicago Police Department and somehow lived. The reason I bring this up is because this is an incredible city of both struggle but also violence and bigotry. And when we think of what we've been able to achieve over the last few weeks with trying to bring up the issues of democracy and inequality in this country, I think all of our minds are looking to the future, to the struggle around the G8 and NATO coming to this city. So I would say to John Carlos and others that the struggle for human rights continues, but also continues in this city, and we may need to have him come back next spring to help us fight for human rights in the city of Chicago. And I hope he accepts our invitation.